What's up guys, Google entry into hardware was the biggest story a few years ago, but the Pixel smartphones, despite the game-changing camera tech and better software experience, just could not manage to make an impact in the Android space, let alone the overall smartphone segment. Anyway, if you want to get video like this, subscribe to this channel will be amazing. The Pixel phones haven't moved many people out of Apple's ecosystem, nor it competed with Samsung's Galaxy Super phones, from Galaxy Note to Galaxy S, that offer all sorts of hardware tricks and different cameras. But 2020 marks the year that Google is making a subtle but significant shift. They're moving out of the premium flagship market. As you already know, Pixel 5 will have a Snapdragon 765G processor instead of the flagship Snapdragon 865. By going with a cheaper chip, Google is expected to conceivably lower its Pixel 5 price down. According to new rumors, the Pixel 5 could cost the same as the first-gen Pixel smartphone, and that is $649. It's rumored to cost 629 euros in Europe, Germany to be specific, and $649 in the United States. It's coming from this person, who accurately leaked the prices of some Samsung products in the past. If Google actually ends up pricing the Pixel 5 at $649, then it'd be going up against companies like OnePlus instead of competing for attention against Samsung's latest Galaxy flagships. The premium phone market, especially in America, is notorious for being tough to compete in unless your brand name is Samsung or Apple. But that upper middle tier area, where phones are premium in nature but not quite hitting the every bell and whistle imaginable, no piece left behind top shelf positioning, is somewhere a company like Google could conceivably have a decent shot at finding its footing. I know what some of you are thinking, that Snapdragon 765G processor, though. But with the right sort of software optimizations and attention to experience, you are absolutely not going to notice or in any way be aware of the difference between a Snapdragon 865 processor and the 765G. Even in games, this chipset is perfectly fine, unless you really crank the user customizable settings in a title like Fortnite, in which case things can stutter. Just don't expect to pull a smooth 90 FPS in demanding titles, and you probably won't be disappointed. And if you don't play a lot of games, you've got even less to worry about. In a new world where the money is tight, people are wearing masks, and flagship phones are starting to cost over $1,300, a $650 price tag for Google's flagship this year could make a world of difference to the end user, in how the phone is perceived and ultimately, if Google plays its cards right, in how well it sells. So what do you think about it? Do let me know your thoughts on that in the comments down below. And if you like this video, subscribe to the channel will be amazing, and my name is Arjun, this is Digital Outside, I'll catch you guys in the next one.